Namaste. Welcome to the next video of Machine Learning Techniques course. In this video, we'll implement loss function of linear regression model from scratch. You recall, and we have talked this multiple times, that the training data in the linear regression model contains features and labels, where labels are the real numbers. The linear regression model obtains a label vector as a linear combination of the features and a weight vector. Concretely, the label vector y can be obtained as a matrix multiplication of the feature matrix and a weight vector. The loss function is computed as half times the square of difference between the predicted label vector and the actual label vector. Let's import the necessary libraries for implementing the loss functions from scratch. We'll also need the inference function that we implemented in the previous collab. So we have copied over that inference function over here. The loss function JW is calculated as half times the square of difference between the predicted label vector and the actual label vector. So all of you know that X is a feature matrix, W is a weight vector, and Y is a label vector. We calculate loss with three arguments. The first is the feature matrix, label vector, and the weight vector. And it returns the loss quantity, which is a scalar number. We first calculate the difference between the predicted label and the actual label vectors. We store that in the vector E. Then we transpose this vector E and multiply it with itself, and the resulting multiplication is multiplied by a quantity of half. That gives us the loss of the model on the training data because of a particular choice of a weight vector. Now that we have implemented this particular function, it's a good idea to test it with a configuration where we work out a test case by hand and use that test case for testing the implementation of the loss function. We use the feature matrix, weight vector, and label vector as we used in the previous collab of the model implementation. The feature matrix already has a dummy feature incorporated in it. The first row represent features of the first example, and the second row represent features of the second example. The weight vector has got four weights. Each one is initialized, or each one has value of 1. And we use a label vector of shape 2 containing two entries. The first entry corresponds to the label of the first training example, and the second entry corresponds to the label of the second training example. Now that we have values of feature matrix, weight vector, and label vector, will compute the loss J of W. So the value of the loss for a particular instantiation of W, where we have used a weight vector containing all ones, it is calculated as the formula that we saw earlier. We'll substitute the values of respective variables and perform the algebraic manipulation. So here we have a matrix vector multiplication, and then the resulting quantity we subtract the actual label vector from the predicted label vector, and we take the transpose of that. In the second bracket, you see exactly the same operation without transpose. So this is the error vector, right? So we take transpose of the error vector and multiply it by itself to obtain the square of difference between the predicted label vector and the actual label vector. So if we continue performing the algebraic manipulation, you will end up with the loss of 62.5 for this particular instance of a weight vector and the training data. So we use exactly this configuration for testing the loss function. So we have inputted the feature matrix, weight vector, label vector, and the expected loss value. Then we call the loss function and record its returned value into the variable loss_value. Then we assert that the loss_value is a scalar quantity, and we also check that this value matches to the expected loss value. So let's run this particular test. Now you see that we pass the test. So the loss implementation of loss works for this particular test case. You know, as I earlier said, you know, these test cases are not exhaustive, and we have sometimes taken a simplified approach to implement these functions, so that you know you get to see how easy it is to implement these various components. I would strongly encourage you to think about more test cases and also more robust ways of implementing some of these components from scratch. In that, you can include various checks like, you know, incompatible matrix operations and so on. But if we implement them right in the beginning, you might feel intimidated, and the main point of showing the simplicity of the implementation will be lost. Hence, we have leaned towards simplified implementation of the functions, and they may not be that robust enough. So, you know, this is some sort of a homework exercise or a thought exercise for you to think about how you can make these implementations robust. Since we have not yet trained our model, we use a random weight vector to calculate the loss for linear regression model. And for that, we use a synthetic data set. We generate a data set with 100 examples and split it into train and test set after adding a dummy variable or dummy feature to it. Then we have written a function to visualize error at each data point. So let us visualize the error for the training set of 100 examples for a particular choice of a weight vector which was chosen randomly in this case. So you can see that because of the randomly chosen weight vector, our current model is shown by this particular blue line over here. And the green dots that you see here are the training points. You see that because of this particular choice of the model, we are incurring certain loss at each training point. And that loss is shown by the vertical red lines. Since we have generated this particular synthetic data set with specific parameters for W0 and W1, we have used the value of 4 for W0 and value of 3 for W1, and we obtained Y as a linear combination that is using the formula 4 plus 3x plus some random noise, and this x was sampled randomly and substituted over here to obtain the value of Y. So now since we know the actual parameters, what we'll do is we will try to visualize the loss for this particular model with the true weight vector of the data generation process. So our weight vector has two values, W0 is set to 4 and W1 is set to 3. And let's visualize this particular loss. You can see that because this is the actual model from which data is getting generated, you know, that model fits the data much better than, let's say, something like this particular model. Here, there are huge errors incurred across almost all training examples. Whereas in this particular figure, the amount of error that we are incurring at different training points is much smaller compared to the earlier figure. So I have a couple of exercises for you. You can plot this loss for the above example with different weight vectors and find out the weight vector that has got the best fitment. And second, I would also encourage you to implement non-vectorized version of loss function and compare the time between vectorized and non-vectorized versions on data sets of different sizes. So I have given some instructions over here. So first you will have to implement a non-vectorized version of loss computation, where for each point you have to calculate the predicted value and then calculate the square of difference between the predicted and the actual values, and then you should sum up these values across all training examples. So that will give you the loss that is computed in a non-vectorized fashion. I would suggest you to generate data sets with different number of samples in them, something like 100, 1000, 10,000, 100,000, 1 million. And for each of these data sets, you should calculate loss with vectorized and non-vectorized versions. And then you should find out the time that it takes to run vectorized and non-vectorized versions, compare those times and note down your observations. So this is some exercise for you to take up in your free time. In the next video, we will study optimization component of the linear regression model.